Build a better mousetrap, and the world will beat a path to your door, or so the saying goes, usually attributed to Ralph Waldo Emerson. What Emerson actually wrote was quite a bit less catchy. If a man has good corn, or wood, or boards, or pigs to sell, or can make better chairs or knives, crucibles or church organs than anybody else, you will find a broad, hard-beaten road to his house, though it be in the woods. Either way, suppose you have made a better chair or crucible or church organ, or indeed a better mousetrap than the 4,400 already patented in the US. You are going to sell your amazing new mousetrap to all those people beating a path to your door. What neither Emerson nor his anonymous paraphrasers told us is how much to charge for it. Surely if you charge too much, the path to your house would not be so well trodden. After all, nobody has to buy your new mousetrap. You can charge as much as you want, but if your price is astronomical, only a couple of wealthy mousetrap collectors will show up at your door, and a couple of sales won't make you much money even if the price is very high. On the other hand, if you set a price too low, your satisfaction from a hard-beaten road to your house might be tempered by your disappointing failure to profit from the years of hard work you put into your invention. So, how should you price in order to make as much money from your invention as possible? Profit is the difference between revenue and costs. So the higher your revenue and the lower your cost, the more profit you make. We focus on costs in our model of the producer, and here we'll focus on the revenue side. You can increase your revenue in two ways, by raising the price or by selling more mousetraps. There is a trade-off between the two. If you raise the price, fewer people will be interested in buying, and if you lower the price, more people will be interested in buying. The key to pricing is to understand this trade-off. If you raise the price and people buy a lot less as a result, then your revenue will likely decrease. But if you raise the price and people buy only a little less as a result, then your revenue will likely increase. So, whether you should charge a higher or a lower price depends on how your potential buyers will respond. Will there be a strong response, a significant change in how many want to buy? Or will there be a weak response with only a small change in how many want to buy? In economics, we use the term price elasticity to describe the responsiveness of buyers' demand to the price of a product. If the quantity demanded falls a lot when price goes up by a dollar, we say that the price elasticity of demand is very high, or that demand is very elastic. In this case, what you gain on each mousetrap sold by charging a higher price will be more than offset by what you lose in selling fewer mousetraps. Raising the price will actually lower revenue, so you would want to lower price. What you would lose on each mousetrap by charging a lower price will be more than offset by the increase in the number of mousetraps you sell. Conversely, if the quantity demanded falls only slightly when price goes up by a dollar, we say that the price elasticity of demand is very low, or that demand is inelastic. In this case, you could raise price and see only a slight fall in the quantity demanded of your product, so you would increase your revenue by raising price. How elastic or inelastic demand is could actually be different at different price levels. It's possible that demand is very inelastic at lower prices, but as you raise price, demand would become more responsive to price or more elastic. The key to finding the profit-maximizing price level is to raise price if demand is inelastic and to lower price if demand is elastic. To set the right price, you would have to keep a close watch on that path to your house to see how traffic changes as you raise your price by a dollar, and you'd have to calculate whether the decrease in traffic has a higher impact on revenue than the increase in price. Perhaps Emerson really said, "Build a better mousetrap, and the world will beat a path to your door." But to get rich, you must understand price elasticity.